Hi guys, hello again. So here we are discussing signatures again, and this time we are going to discuss how the signature is formed. Usually signatures has a lot of things, you know, your name, your father's name, your initial, your surname and all. So everything which is there in the signature has some kind of significance. So today in the remaining of the video, you are going to get insight about how the signature is formed and how you behave when you have a particular kind of signature. For start, I'm going to tell you a few things. Let's assume there are three things: your name, your father's name, your surname. So your name will tell you the way you behave yourself, the way you write your father's name is the way your father behave, is the way you are going to behave as a father, and the way you write your signature, surname, that will tell you the way you are going to behave as emotional person or motherly behavior. So guys, enjoy the rest of the video and learn about the signatures. So guys, as discussed, let's assume this is the name of the person. Let's assume this is the name of the person. So if the person signs something, let's assume he signs as Kadam. Okay, now the signature would be divided into three parts. First, his own initials. Second, his father or his Kumar or any other things, you know, the second thing, and the third one will be the surname. Now the surname will also have a three parts. First will be the initial of the surname, and remainder will be the remaining part of the surname. So the first letter, the way you write for the first letter, the way you write your name will always describe the things about yourself. Okay, so the first initial of your signature will be always describing yourself. The second initial, whatever it may be, you know, if the father's name is there, then it would be the way father and you as a father. Third, if father name is not there, and let's assume some people is writing Sudhir Kuma. So Kumar is there, but father is not there. You know, father's name is not there. Then Kuma will be treated as a father. Okay, so the way he or she writes Kuma will be the way they behave as a fatherly, or the way they behave as a father. So the second initial will be for your father. Okay, the way the second letter is been written will indicate the way they perceive father and the way they will behave as a father. Okay, now third, this is a letter which will be a family. See, this is your family name. Okay, family name in the sense, this is the name which is carried forward. So the first initial of your signature's surname will be indicating the way you treat family, or the way you perceive family, or the way you behave emotionally. Family again is a very emotional matter. And the remaining part of signature, this part, particularly this part, this is the way you occupy your time. See, we are not saying this as a profession, but we are saying this is a occupation. So the way you occupy your time will be shown by the way you write the remainder of your signature. So as discussed, the first letter of your name, or the your name, or whatever you sign, the initial thing, the way you write your name, will be describing the way you treat yourself, the way you behave yourself, the way you think about yourself. The second part of your signature, where you put initial of your father, or you write something ahead of your name, then that thing will be considered as a father. And the way you write that letter will be showing the way you treat father, the way you behave as a father, the way father has behaved with you. Okay. And the number third letter will be for family. Family also means your wife and your children. Okay, these are the people who are responsible for carrying your family name. Okay, so these things will be also described by the initial of your signature, and the remainder of your signature will be shown as the occupation, in the sense the way you occupy your time. So guys, this is how you can analyze a simple signature. You can just see the way the person has written the first initial, second initial and third initial, and it's easy for you to know the way that person thinks about himself or the person behaves about family or father, or the way they occupy their time. So guys, do like to our videos, comment, subscribe to our videos, and we will give you more knowledge about graphology. And we are doing a lot of study regarding the scientific ways of doing things, and we are into branding, scientifically branding. The way we brand, we do the things, will impact subconscious directly, and it will be easy for you to manifest things if you use our own designed branding. Okay, thank you very much.